you're just a peasant in medieval times when a necromancer who's up to no good comes and starts making some trouble in your neighborhood. You got into one little fight. Actually, it's gonna be a lot more than one. This is Zombicide Black Plague. Black Plague takes place in the medieval times with sword and sorcery and, of course, zombies. Now, during this gameplay video, you're gonna notice that some of the pieces don't look quite final. That's because they are prototype pieces. So this is not representative of what you're gonna get in your box. But you will get to see some of the new rules and the new zombies and the new items. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. Hey guys, here we are today with Zombicide Black Plague.
Sweet.
It's the Zombicide you know and love. Just a little...
Plaguier.
Plaguier. It's right. Got a little bit of plague in it.
Right.
The rules are a little bit different than standard Zombicide, but as you'll see, I think it's very... The way that they've changed the game is very exciting. But before we actually get into the game and the mission that we're doing, why don't we introduce ourselves and the players, the characters that we're playing as. I'm Spencer Reeve. I'm the marketing executive for Cool Mini or Not. And I am playing as Clovis the Warrior.
Well, I am Steve Avery, and I am playing as Anna the Nun. But she's bloodthirsty.
She's got a little bit of bloodthirst.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she has a sword.
No problems there whatsoever.
No.
I'm Tim. I work sales for Cool Mini or Not. I am playing Silas the Elf.
I'm Jared. I am the editor-in-chief of Tabletop Gaming News, and I'm playing Baldrick, a wise old wizard.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty jealous.
A bit of a...
So wise.
Disconnect there.
And you're right, because you're totally like Annie the Nun.
That's right. Don't let me get my ruler after you. All right, so tell us about Black Plague.
Okay, man. So Black Plague takes place in a different time than the other Zombicides have. And then because of that, the rules have changed a little bit. Characters are different. It's almost like a different timeline, because the other Zombicide games actually are an overarching story. They kind of tie them all together, and there are events that are occurring. This is a different timeline, and there's a different zombie problem. Zombies are still the problem, but there's necromancers who are raising them and kind of causing these poor medieval peasants to have to deal with all these deadly zombies.
Curse you, necromancers.
I know.
They don't have enough to deal with.
I mean, just getting food alone back in these days was rough, but now you got zombies. In this particular mission, we're actually going to be playing the mission that's called Big Game Hunting. But the thing is, people should be aware, this is actually slightly modified. We've reduced some of the number of searchable areas because we're trying to just kind of make a quicker version of the game for the video, right? What the objective is for us is we need to kill one abomination and we need to kill one necromancer. And we also need to find the blue token that is hidden face down.
I got this.
Should be no problem, right?
No problem.
So split up?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I think that basically okay. Splitting up Perfect. Is the best plan. Yeah. And so there's a couple new rules with this version of Zombicide that things play a little bit differently, but that's something that we'll touch on as we move on. So why don't we just jump in.
Let's get the action.
To Zombicide Black Plague. Mm-hmm. All right, so the first things first, I'm looking at these X's and I know I need to get them. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to start. I'm actually first player, but you stole the first player token and put it on your finger.
Spencer.
Appreciate that. Yeah, we're using our Zombicide Season 2 first player token. I'm going to start and I'm going to move my warrior here, Clovis. I'm going to use his starting action is one additional die when he does melee, but I don't need that quite yet. So I'm going to go right here. That's going to be one. I'm going to open this door using, I have a hammer. Now, the thing is with the hammer, again, this is one of the different rules. I can use the hammer to break the door open, but now I actually have to roll for success. So the hammer has an icon that says I need a 4 or better to break the door open. So this will be my second action. Got a 5, right. Knock it open. That leaves a noise token because just smash the door with a hammer. It's kind of loud.
Smash the door.
All right, so I now have to do classic Zombicide. I have to spawn what's inside the room. So the first room, we've got no one.
Wow, nothing.
Good job.
Good going, Clovis. And the second room over here, we have one walker. Just grab me a walker. And we'll...
This one?
Yep. Of course you pick the easy room.
Yep. And I know I need to get that X, and I can also use these new trapdoor looking things that will that take us down into the vaults, which we'll talk about when we get into that. I'm gonna go ahead and risk it, and third and final action, just go in there, say.
Chill out, man.
Getting crazy.
Come here, zombie.
Nice.
Getting crazy.
Very nice.
All right, Steve.
Man, I, you know what? That, you got that. I'm going to a different way. I'm going to
might as well.
This other room. Why? Because I'm a crazy bloodthirsty nun. One. Second action is a smash the door. Boom.
Got it.
I make noise all
You
time.
Make noise when you
break
the door.
I don't smash the door. I take my short sword and pry it open.
You pry it open. You have a little bit more skill than my brute force.
So what do we got in here? Survey says, ooh, double spawn. All right, so first up, looks like I got a fatty.
Oh, fatty. So well, drop him in there.
Kind of bad news since I cannot actually kill a fatty.
That's right.
And next up, I have another fatty. Awesome. Two fatties.
Sweet.
Wow. Great stars.
Sweet.
None knows how to pick them.
Okay, so I've used two actions, right? As much as I'd love to run in there, get that. I'm thinking I'm probably going to run away now.
That's not a bad choice. Although, unlike previous zombicides where you only had two hits, you now have three. So you could go in there.
Yeah.
And get hit. You couldn't even pick it up. You could just get hit.
Exactly. And then I wouldn't be able to get away because there'd be more zombies than me. So I'm going to run away. That's my third action.
Good job.
Thank you.
Brave old Steve Avery.
Broke a door open. Good luck.
It's too scary.
Guys, I have to go.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and be a team player here. I'm going to help Spencer out a little bit. We use two actions to move into the room.
A real team player would take on those two fatties.
No, you're good.
Not with the short bow that I got dealt. So I'm going to go ahead and fire at this last zombie in the room over there. Now, normally I hit on a 3-up. However, with my skill plus one to dice will range, I hit anything with a 2-up on dice. And that's a 2, which is enough to kill that zombie.
Just coming in right under the...
kind of barely.
Yeah.
Hey, that's all right.
He's a sloppy. He's a sloppy bowman.
Yes. We're going to go with that.
All right, so you have left me with poor choices over there. So
you can open that door.
I could, but I'm actually going to move into this room and hang out with all the cool kids.
He actually couldn't open any doors. He doesn't have the equipment to do it.
Oh.
So I've got two actions moving into there. I've got one more, so I'm just going to go ahead and search.
Oh, yeah. Give him a search. See what he gets.
What do I get here? Got a shield. Put that right here. So shields are actually new.
All right, so the way that shields work basically is that now that there's armor and shields in the game, when you get attacked by a zombie, you don't automatically take the hit. When you have a shield equipped in your hand, it works like armor does. Armor automatically when it's on your character's card, as you can see on the dashboard, we have two hands and then we actually have a top right spot for the armor to go. When the armor is laid on, you when you're attacked, you have a certain die roll that you roll to see if the attack is successful. So if you roll over a certain number, you can negate the number of attacks dies that you rolled, right? With the shield, it's the same deal, except it has to be in your one of your hands, unless your character has a armor ability, like in your case, Annie has a dagger that she can wear. In my case, Clovis can actually wear a shield as armor, so it doesn't have to be in his hands.
Cool, all right.
Yeah, I like the new dashboard. So I like the little slots here.
For the backpack,
Backpacks and how the pegs, you can pick out your skills that way. Very, very clean.
All right, so that is my three actions.
All right, so that is the turn. So let's do a zombie move. Those guys are gonna jump out of that room.
Hey, Annie.
Oops.
Because they see her and they go for her. And now we're gonna spawn at the two spawn locations. So there's over by Tim. Remember
this one here?
Yep. We got one walker.
One walker.
Not bad.
And down at the other end, we get one fatty, because we're all still in blue.
Yeah, we're fattying it up.
Just like old Zombicide, the highest level character determines the spawn. Looking at the card, we're all still in blue, so.
Oh, I forgot. I'm gonna start at zero. Kind of cheat right off the bat.
Yeah, thanks for doing that. At least you caught. You're like, you know what? My guilty conscience.
Yeah.
And the those experience trackers are actually built into the dashboard.
Yeah, that's
now,
super cool. Yeah, and it actually has a sweet slider at the bottom.
Yeah.
Yeah, the new dashboards are one of the coolest things about the game for sure. I mean, the new mechanics are quite awesome, but the first time you see one of these, you're just like, this is so awesome.
Hey guys, I'm bringing some friends.
All right, man.
What's the party?
It's on you. You're first player, so.
Oh, I am. All right. So as first player, well, this goes away also.
Oh yeah, these go away. Yeah, sure.
As first player, I will run.
Fair
one,
enough.
Two, And I'll search for a third action.
Nice.
Come on, fatty killer. A longbow. Very nice. Now let me ask you, does it take action to give that to him?
To trade, yes. Mm-hmm. It is one action to trade.
Now, I got a present for you, Tim.
Okay.
He can trade with you on his turn, which is his turn now.
Right, so I'm going to go ahead and spend my first action to trade. You'll get the short bow, and I'll take this longbow.
Sounds good.
Not a bad idea.
However, that longbow is still not going to be able to hurt the fatty, so I'm going to spend another action to search the room as well.
Nice.
And I got a shield, which will definitely help when I'm being attacked by fatties. And then,
which will be soon.
Yeah, which will be soon. So I'm going to go ahead and run into this room. Because, right. You know, I'm brave and all.
Trying to get as far away from those fatties as possible.
Exactly.
All right, so I am going to do a similar thing and move into here. I'm going to go ahead and take this objective.
Oh, you, that was my
job. Yeah, lame.
Don't worry, guys. I got this. I didn't want you guys to be burdened. So
I can pick up this bat loot experience point.
When I get one of those, I get 5 experience because I did a lot of hard work. So that is 2 actions. And, I think I will... I'm just going to move back in here, since I did all that hard lifting.
Your whole turn consists of running, gaining 5 experience points, and running back.
Yeah.
Right. You will notice I have more experience than you, though, that's so true. Obviously I did something right.
It's true. So. And you didn't spawn extra fatties.
Yeah, I mean, you've really wrecked this.
I'm luring them.
So. All right.
What you got?
The conference is over, gentlemen.
You're going to go take that fatty out.
I'm going to run over... No, I don't have enough actions to do that. But I will. I have a plan. Because my hammer does 2 damage. So I could start wrecking fatties. But first, I'm going to pop this vault open. So I'm going to roll for... to see if I can break it open with my hammer. I don't. That's my first action.
Boom.
Yeah, thank you. My second action. I do.
Nice.
So you break it open.
All right.
Now, vaults are new, and the way that vaults work is they're color-coded. So this yellow vault's going to lead me to this yellow door is going to lead me to this yellow vault. And this one can actually exit through that yellow vault over there. So they almost like shortcuts. Cool. One thing that's also cool is that zombies don't actually spawn when you go into a vault.
Good nice. Place to hide.
It is, so it's a really good place to hide. However, zombies will follow you into a vault if they're chasing you down. So you can't just hang out there.
You hide there temporarily.
So not a great place to
hide. Yeah, it's a good place.
It's just a good place.
Right, it's an okay place to hide.
It's a good place to catch a breather.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I have, that's 2 of my actions. My third action, I am going to, you know what, man?
That's it. Go face them.
You got this.
Clovis. Bring him to Clovis.
All right.
Well, that's end of the turn.
Let's move our zombies.
So,
come get some fatties. Oh man, they're gonna get so wrecked. I don't even know.
Oh, we gotta move that one.
And the sound comes off.
Yep. And now we spawn.
That's exciting.
Over by Tim.
What do we got?
1 runner. Those are pretty bad. And down there, we have 1 walker.
I'm not up on my zombie side lore like you guys. I know these are all new skulls. Are these also new skulls?
Yes, they're all peasants and villagers, man. There's
I just noticed that these fatties are both different, but they're pretty neat, actually. A little... What is that guy? He's like a merchant or something?
His name was Jeremiah.
That's right. The apple merchant.
What is going on right now? Jeremiah the apple merchant.
Alright, so anyways.
You know what the best part of hanging out with you, Steve, is?
Squirrel!
The ADHD child that is still buried somewhere deep inside. Look at this one!
Alright, so I guess I start the turn now. My bow's not strong enough to kill a fatty, so... I think
could shoot Spencer in the back.
I could shoot Spencer in the back, but that's not being a good team player, Steve. Come on now. So I'm going to go ahead and run into this room, and I'm going to go down into the vault. And I'm going to go ahead and find out what this is. And it's an Inferno spell that I pretty much can't use. I'm not the wizard.
Well, you can use it. It's just you're not going to benefit as well.
I'm not going to be as awesome as our awesome wizard over there that does nothing.
The wise wizard who has more experience than me.
Yeah, that one. Here, we'll go with that. So that'll end my turn.
All right, so now it is the Wise Wizard's turn. And he is going to say hello and see about maybe trading.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
So, in a trade, do I actually have to give him anything?
No, you don't have to. You take something from him and you can rearrange.
Because you already have a shield, right?
I do already have a shield.
That's how you trade, Jared.
Well,
you take stuff and you don't give anything back.
It makes sense that I'll hold on to my spell because I have an ability later that lets me use spells that aren't equipped. So, when I trade, I can do switching for free.
Yeah, you do for, yeah.
So, I've now got Inferno equipped, which is a 2 damage spell, so I am now more equipped to actually deal with fatties as well. So, I will move back out here.
He's coming back for him.
So,
very awesome. Nice.
Then, let's see. All right, that was my 3 actions, and yeah, okay.
Now it's my turn.
It is.
You guys might want to get up the notebook and start taking some notes. Because Clovis is about to show you how to handle a couple of fatties.
All right, go down.
So the number one thing about fatties that we've hinted at, but we haven't clarified yet, is that you have to have a weapon that does 2 damage to be able to kill them. My hammer does, which is awesome. And my hammer also hits on a 4+, but I get +1 die to melee as Clovis. So I roll 2 dies. So I've used 1 action to get over there. I can't imagine this going wrong. By the way, I'm looking at it and going, what could go wrong? Okay, I hit a 6. Nice. We are using our zombicide dice with the Molotov cocktails. Maybe there'll be some zombicide dice that have, I don't know. We'll see. That's a surprise. So I kill one of them.
All right.
That's excellent. 1 action. And now, I'm going to roll again. Now, I actually don't create sound when I kill with the hammer.
It's kind of a squishy, gnashing noise.
Yeah, a little bit. Okay. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
How's that noise go again?
Well, okay, so I didn't quite...
It sounds like a whiff.
Yeah. I did...
Whooshing noise.
All right, look, guys. Clovis can't be everything to all people. You know what I mean?
Right. I took notes.
Well, he's about to be lunch.
So I...
He could be lunch to that zombie.
So I kill once, I get 1 experience, and that was my turn.
All right, I'm going to search for something awesome. Bam! Dragon Bile.
Oh, awesome.
I'm going to stick that in my pack.
So, yeah, Dragon Bile is actually another new item. There's a lot of new items, but it replaces the Molotov cocktail. And in the old Molotov cocktails, you needed the 2 items to add together. You needed the bottle and the gasoline. And now what you need is the Dragon Bile and a torch. But what's cool about Dragon Bile is you can actually just throw the Dragon Bile on the ground.
Yeah, it's got these cool tiles here.
Yep.
And you might have to lure the abomination in.
Yeah, and then you lure him in, and then you throw a torch in.
Lord Jared.
Well, that's not how you play the game, Steve.
It's alternate rules.
You're playing.
It's
like... making up a lot of house rules on the fly
it's
here.
It's like Black Flag Last Man Standing.
Yeah.
It's totally... It's going to be in the errata. Alright, so action 2 is to go through here, and action 3 is to try to break open that door over there. So, smash!
No.
Oh,
but you did attempt, so you put a little.
Yeah, I make noise. Okay, and that's it for me.
All right, and that actually ends the turn.
Yep.
Oh, boy.
Num.
All right, so zombies activate. I take a wound because I thought I was going to be a champ.
You have a few more left, though. Well, a couple more.
I thought I was going to be a champ. Turned out to be a chomp.
Yeah, so with this, you don't actually lose equipment like you did in the old Zombicide.
Yeah, you don't. When you get hit, you don't lose equipment like you did in the old Zombicide. You just take the wound. You can take up the 3.
I think they made some smart rules decisions in this one.
Oh, I agree. And now this dude moves, and this guy moves right here, and then that guy moves there. And this guy, the runner, activates. He gets 2 activations as opposed to the fatties and the walker standard 1, so he's going to go 1-2, which means he moves quicker, runner. But he also, if he starts in your square, hits you twice. So super deadly. Again, same rules for these zombies as the previous games, but if you're new to the Zombicide games, see how they work here.
Awesome. Okay.
Now so we need to spawn. Yep. So let's flip this one over. Nothing.
Nice.
All right. And what do you got over there?
And over there we've got 2 walkers. Is that what they sound like?
I do.
Thanks for clarifying that for me. There's blood in the water, man. Or, well, on the street, kinda.
All All right.
All right. So you are actually first player.
Haha. So, first thing I'm going to do is search.
Fair enough.
We got a torch. So
Nice.
That will come in handy later. So I'll just put that in my backpack.
Hey, as an action, do you want me to hand off the dragon bile so you can both the torch and the bile?
We'll see. I gotta do some business over here. I gotta save Clovis.
Oh, I thought you were in my room. You're not.
Yeah, no, not right now.
That's him.
So second action, I am going to move up there. Third action, I'll go ahead and attack with the Inferno because it actually deals 2 damage.
Before you roll, let's so that people know, this is actually another rules change too. You are firing a ranged weapon into my square. It used to be target priority would be that you would hit survivors first. Mm. Now you only hit survivors on a fail.
Now see, that's a smart rules change.
Yeah, it's
that's one of my favorites.
Yeah. So it has risk reward now, right? It used to be there was no reward. It was just you just shoot the survivor and go.
Well, I see it. It's good. You're good either way.
How you're playing it, definitely. Yes. All right. Oh man.
Wow. Yep. Wow. That's
take your pick.
Super dead zombie.
Yep.
Appreciate that.
Now, had he hit you, you would have taken 2 damage. And that's a 2 damage weapon, right?
Yeah. My skill actually as the wizard, I have spellcaster, so I got a free magic action. So that was my free magic action.
Oh,
so
awesome.
What I'm gonna go ahead and do is actually move up one more to hang out with you.
Hey, thanks, man. Just hanging out.
That puts me at 6. Dangerously close to yellow.
How did you kill so many so fast?
I'm just really good at picking up things.
Oh yeah, the fire. Yeah. Yeah. I was like, wait.
I'm good at picking up X's.
I was like, wait, yeah. How did he kill? Oh, yeah, he got the X, yeah. Okay.
He's wise.
He's really smart. He's got a lot of experience. All right, my turn. Yeah, I'm gonna go for that. I'm gonna go for that X. I do want to kind of hit that fatty in the head, but I'm gonna go for that X. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, move in here, pick up this X.
You're welcome.
Just a standard one. That gives me 5 experience. Boom, puts me at 6. I'm just as a wise wizard, man.
And I was still taking notes, and I did note that the warrior ran from battle.
I said
so.
I learned my lesson.
We also.
I'm really not okay with.
Is that your third action?
That was my third.
All right, my first is to crack this door open. Come on. Yes.
All right.
Boom. What we got?
Luckily, there's a noise token already there.
Yes.
Because you forgot to move it.
We just knew it was
going to happen. It's here instead. It's a totally different place.
Yeah.
All right. So double spawns. So what? This chamber is
so
empty.
That is empty, and then we move into these. Yeah. So starting in that first.
The necromancer.
All right,
so we got the necro there.
So before we move on, let's talk about the necromancer very quickly because he actually changes the spawn order and stuff like that because he's one of the new unique models. In the previous Zombicides, the abomination was a unique model. You had your fatties, your walkers, your runners, and then you had the one abomination.
And really, the whole reason we're fighting right now.
Yeah, and the whole reason we're fighting is because of these necromancers. They're an important character in the lore of Zombicide Black Plague, but they're an important model too because when they spawn, they actually drop a necromancer spawn point. So we have to take a necromancer spawn point and throw it on the table.
Okay, so I got one here.
Yeah, so it falls right in his tile.
Right in his tile, all right.
And now he is going to spawn zombies for that spawn point. So that's our next spawn card.
Bam, his friends, two walkers.
All right, so we put 2 walkers down for there.
All right. Always good to have friends along.
And now we still have to continue our spawning for the rooms.
We have a double spawn still in that room.
Yeah, we still have a double spawn in that room, so that room's not clear yet. But one thing we need to note is that's how he starts when he activates, when he first arrives. That's what he does automatically. Now, what he's going to attempt to do for the rest of this game is he's going to try to find the nearest spawn point that isn't his own, so one of these red ones is already on the board, and get out. Leave the map. And if he succeeds in doing that, his purple spawn point that we just put down becomes permanent, and zombies are always going to spawn there for the rest of the game.
Gross.
That sounds bad.
If we kill him, though, we get to destroy any spawn point, be it the purple one or one of the 2 red ones. So we can kind of decide which way we want to try to crowd control the spawning zombies, right? Which way is the best for us. So there is that's the necromancer, kind of a brief overview of what he does. And as you said, we have the double spawn card, so we have to spawn again for that room.
Here's with 2 more walkers.
Sweet.
Walker. Right. He's four walkers.
He's got some friends with him.
And then in the next little stall, one walker.
Not as bad as the room before.
And then in the next stall, double spawns.
So this room's going to stay empty, and we're going to cycle back to the first room, and you're going to pull two spawn cards for Ed.
Oh, that's a bummer. Yeah. I can't run in.
Well, you mean that
I was going to pull a Jerry.
Yeah, well,
and get that experience in it without actually.
You mean
but you're not as skilled.
Let me just understand. You mean things aren't going smoothly for you in a game of Zombicide?
I wanted to get a whole bunch of experience without actually doing anything.
Oh, know?
Well,
yeah. So okay.
A
fatty, which I can't fight.
Great. And
a walker.
Okay,
so that's not too terrible.
That's not terrible. Wait, so you can move in there, but you've opened. Move in, pick up. All right, you can't leave in time. That's true.
I say you give it a shot.
What's the worst that can happen?
Yeah.
I mean, take it from me. I know what the worst that can happen is.
So yeah, now I get overrun. I have to search. Search. Leather armor. Sweet.
Oh, awesome. So, yeah, that right. Armor fits right there in the top of your...
Five plus. Yep. Five plus for leather armor.
Yep. Nice. So, basically, you need to roll...
So, I'm a nun in leather. Awesome. Looking good.
This is a kid's game, Steve Avery.
Of course it is.
So, yeah, you need to roll a five plus to negate any hits.
All right. And so, for my last action, I'm guessing that we're going to have to move out.
You've got armor. You should just go ahead and...
I would fight those, but these guys are going to move in the next round, and I'll be
pinned.
You
got armor. It's fine. You got armor now.
I'll be pinned.
Just go in there, Steve.
I'll push Tim in and close the door behind me.
I don't know.
I don't think you can close a broken door.
Run back away. I've done a lot of running so far.
Okay. Yeah, I think I'm also going to, be brave and run away as well, so.
Brave Sir Robin.
Exactly. I'm going to go ahead and search the room as well. And I get a dagger, so it's going to just go ahead and go in my backpack right now. And then I'm going to run out here, and then I'm going to move out with a robe there.
Let me ask you, I've got a dagger as my... I can slot a dagger here, yeah. So that would give me an extra attack, right, if I slot it there?
It means that dagger is actually available for you to use as one of your items instead of it just being the two in the hand. Because you can only use these as attacks.
Okay.
But that means you can use that instead of the armor, but then you'd be giving up your armor to do that.
I see.
Okay. Yeah, it's like you have like an armor ability and where you can slot your armor or a different item that's kind of an armor ability item, right? Like a dagger.
Gotcha. Okay. And is that it?
Yeah, that's everything.
So we are to the movement, and now in the interest of fairness before anyone moves, I did forget to put
noise second.
I did create quite the inferno over there. So
you blew some stuff up.
Yes.
All right, so these guys are going to move towards the loudest spot on the map. These guys are actually going to move down here.
Into the vault,
because they're going to come after their...
That was such a good hiding space.
Yeah, well,
it was.
It was decent.
Somebody ruined it. All of those guys will move into that room. Yep. Not him, though.
He's
in the other... He's not part of the party.
Yeah.
He's not part of the party. They left him out.
Now that necromancer, can he go through the doors, or does he have to take the long way around?
He's gonna have to take the long way around.
All right.
So the doors are sealed up, right? They have to be broken.
We boarded them up because we knew there were necromancers around.
Well, yeah. You board up your doors and there's necromancers in town. All right, and then this guy has to move forward, right?
Nope.
Oh, he broke
there.
Sorry.
Yep.
All right.
You got it.
Sweet. Now we need to spawn.
All right. This sounds like
spawn by Tim. Yep.
All right.
And we're gonna spawn. We're still in blue, right?
Yep.
Yes, we are.
Yes. Nothing inside.
Nice.
Okay. Nice.
Go ahead, necromancer.
Necromancer spawn point actually is another necromancer, which means he actually just gets another activation. So he moves into the vault.
Nice.
Coming.
He's
on
the move.
He's chasing us.
I'm coming for you, Steve Avery. That's how he talks. He's been smoking.
That's why he's dead.
He's not dead. He's a necromancer.
You don't know that.
I know. One walker at the final spawn.
All right.
Not too bad.
You gotta read up on your lore, man. All
right. I like the way this is shaping up.
And so we pass the first player token.
Clear this. And we already got the one over there.
Yeah, took the one over there.
I could come out, and I could hit that dude in the head.
You could, but that wouldn't be like a warrior.
But here would really do. is swing his hammer at the door.
Yep.
I'm gonna try to go in that vault. So I'm gonna roll.
What?
I rolled a two. All right. That's not good. So I'm gonna roll again. I rolled a three.
All right.
That's my second activation. That's two noise
tokens. Making a lot of noise in there.
And final activation, six, of course.
Wow.
Third time's a charm, as they say. And that's all I've done in my turn. So
you're just like knocking stuff over.
Clovis really taking care of business
in there.
Are you
sure you're not playing the blind drunkard? Like,
I swear I'm a warrior. All right, well, that's my turn. Go ahead, Steve.
I'm searching, still searching for something that can kill fatties. A dagger, which I'll put in my backpack.
It's good to have a dagger in the backpack.
You know where you should go.
Yeah, you should just go in there.
Hug it out. Go out there and hug it out.
You got armor, remember.
One. Two.
That's a good idea. Not a bad idea, Steve.
Okay, so my turn, huh? This longbow's great. I still can't kill that bag.
You should beat Steve to that door.
So I'm just gonna go in here and search and see if I can finally get something powerful enough to kill a fatty. I got a lightning bolt spell.
Nice.
Lightning bolt.
Does it still can't kill a fatty.
Does it do one damage? Classic.
Only does one damage. And I'm just gonna go ahead and walk back out here. And I'm just gonna wait to shoot the necromancer in the face.
All right. I guess I'll actually do something.
Yeah, take care of business while wizard.
So, let's go for this fatty first. And he's
dead. It is dead.
Hit him.
Then you bump up into yellow.
Ooh, now we're in yellow.
And what is
your... get plus one action. So this is one of the other neat things. Yep. You can track our skills now. So I already had one at my starting. Now I'll put another one of these pegs here so I know I have plus one action. That means I have four actions because that spell was free. So I'll go ahead and move here. Use an action to shoot one of those guys there.
So you have four dice, so you can potentially hit both of them.
Both of them, yeah. That's a good point.
Yeah, I'm trying to help you out. And you do.
Yeah. So
boom, boom.
Nice.
So we need a noise token there.
Here, yep. And then
there.
Here.
Yeah.
There we go. Some more experience. Got three more actions. So let's go ahead and go for this spot here.
Going for broke, huh?
Oh yeah, why not?
Boom!
And kill both of those.
Just cleaning up. Aldrich's doing some real work, I'm gonna be honest with you.
I'll go ahead and put another one of these here. And I got one more. So let's go for that guy. And I do it.
Yeah, he is way dead.
Extremely dead.
Nice work, Baldrick.
Thanks.
What would we do without you?
I
seem to recall someone saying the wizard wasn't really doing anything.
I want to point out that Baldrick only produced one more noise token in my attempt to open the door.
Blowing up half the city.
Just fire everywhere.
All right.
All right, so
that's it.
Yeah, spawn time.
So zombies move.
Yeah, they move.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Zombies move first.
So this guy obviously wants some.
These guys heard a lot of commotion, so they're gonna come check out the scene.
All right, and then
those guys move into the vault.
Guys move into the vault,
and that one
guys
little guy's
still gonna be trying to catch
wait
up.
Wait for me! All right, and now we spawn. So over there by Tim. We have nothing. Oh no! Sorry,
we're in
two
yellow.
Runners. We're in yellow.
Nice.
Thanks, Baldrick.
I'll get him closer to the fire.
The necromancer spawn point. We get a double spawn. So actually, we're going to move over to the next spawn point
okay.
and
good.
Pull two cards.
Awesome.
One fatty.
No problem.
And one abomination.
No problem.
That is.
Roll the abominations out.
So just to brush up for people who may have forgotten or haven't played the other Zombicides, an abomination is a 3-hit point enemy. So you have to have a weapon that does 3 points of damage. There's only one in the game. That's the Dragon Bile, which you have to throw on the ground and then use the torch to blow up. So you guys might need to coordinate, take care
he's
of that
way
guy.
Over there. Me and the Abomination, I can't be troubled, yo. Besides, he's doing so well with the Inferno.
There you go.
I think you should maybe come on over.
Alright, I am going to come over. How far can I throw this? The adjacent space?
Yeah, I believe if you check the card.
What?
If you look, read it? You actually just drop it. So you put it.
I can't even.
Oh no, I'm sorry. Excuse me. It's 0-1. Excuse me. It's 0-1.
All right.
So the same space or one space
out. I'm here to help you out.
Awesome.
Does it take an action to throw it?
Yes, it's an item. Well, number one, you have to use.
You okay there?
You know what? Look, okay? Number one, Steve, could you please move your arm? God, I'm trying to help you out. You're like a child. God. All right. So, are you ready to learn?
I'm ready.
Are you ready to learn, Steve Avery? Okay, here's how it works. You're going to have to use one action to pull it out of your backpack to put it in your hand. Yeah, I know. It's a game. It has rules.
It's so hard.
And then you're going to have to use it either in the space you're on or the space in one space adjacent to you.
Okay. I got the dragon bio. Here I come. 1, 2, 3.
All right.
Perfect. I really wanted to throw it in his space.
You know, if you got a little more experience, you could have had that extra action and have done that switcheroo.
Hand me that spell. Good.
All right, so can't get to the necromancer, but I can kill that walker, so I'm gonna go ahead and just fire into the room and shoot that walker, which I'll hit it on a 2+. I do, so that's a walker that's dead moves me up, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and move 2 spaces back and join the party.
So far I've killed zero.
Yeah, you're doing real good.
Yeah, you've done a lot of talking about killing
carrying
us.
Your weight. Yeah, so yeah, there's a lot of betrayal talk.
I was gonna pick up that axe. All right, Jared, but too hard.
So let's see here. Maybe I'll do something. So first, I'm just going to try to pick this guy off. And I do it.
Successfully.
Nice.
Bump that up a little bit.
This guy right is really there. Just doing work over there.
So I got 4. Let's see. You know what? I'll be back. Don't worry. 1, 2, and I'm gonna search in there.
What?
Just don't worry. It's fine. I got Dragon Ball. I don't even need you.
Nice.
I don't even need you. And I'll just poke my head back out here.
How many actions is it to steal stuff from his?
Yeah. That's house rules, dog.
Alright, so there we go. You can go. I don't know what you're doing, but it's you first.
It's my turn.
Oh, you finally had that door open.
I'm gonna go into here. Find out what's in the vault. It's an orcish crossbow.
It'd be really good for someone who's ranged.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It sounds like it would be fantastic.
Or it'd be really good for.
So actually, one of the things I don't think we mentioned about the vault that's interesting about these items is that the reason why this inferno might seem pretty powerful and the orcish crossbow.
Same with the crossbow, yeah, exactly.
Is that the vaults actually contain, as you saw, they have these special items that you can only get through there.
Yeah, it's like the guns in the cars of the previous games, right?
So
it's a special item, right? It's a special item in that vault.
I'd still be awesome without it, just to be clear.
It doesn't hurt that you have it, though.
Right.
Wasn't that given to you?
Well, I mean, if I had a nice crossbow, I would have given it to him. But, you know, unfortunately, someone else found it.
So that's right. That's my one action. I'm actually going to, do some other work, and I'm gonna roll my die here. So that was one action. I'm gonna roll my die to pop this door open, the other side of this vault door open. Boom! Got it.
Boom!
Cracked it open.
One shot.
So that goes over there.
Oh, does it not go? Okay, gotcha.
Oh. I figure the door's opening over
there. Yeah.
And this is quite a large room.
So we need to spawn for this room. So we'll start here.
All right.
Flip it. We get 3 walkers.
It's going to be fun in there.
Next room, we get 2 fatties. As I heard, this room was pretty good. Third room, we get 1 runner. The next, middle room there, we get 4 walkers.
Pretty good. Pretty good. If we were in yellow, it'd be pretty boring in here.
We'll start right here.
Okay.
We've got 3 walkers. It's fine.
It's really fine.
I'll be there.
The one in the middle there, we've got three walkers. One at the edge there, we have one runner.
All right.
Just one.
We're not done yet.
Next to room down, we have one runner. Just good. That's good. You guys just pile in. And we have one fatty.
All right.
Right where we need to go, actually. So
This is good.
So it's one action to move in there, one action to open the door, and one action to pick up the item. That's my three actions, because I'm just barely shy of that yellow. All right. So that's everybody's turn, right?
Yes. Yep. So zombies get to move.
So everybody gets to move. Let's start with those runners right there. They go one, two.
Yep.
That guy's going to move. Finally move into the vault. These guys will move out of the vault.
And these guys
will move out into the street. So there and there.
Zavon will move forward with the fatty.
Yep. And then all of this nightmare will begin. Oh, what's up, guys? Guys. I made a huge mistake
right there.
Yeah. So
that runner, one, two. Guys, it's not looking
good.
That's perfect.
One, two.
Yeah.
Got all this.
One, yeah, they move in there. They move over. He's going to go one, two. Two. Yeah.
He'll go one.
Yeah.
That's not bad. I've seen worse.
It's fine. I've seen worse. Now we need to spawn. So over there, that by Tim, we've got two walkers.
Okay. The Necromancer?
Necromancer, we've got three walkers. Oh, man. And down there, the other one, we have four walkers.
That's not bad.
No runners, no fatties. That's pretty good. Now.
All right, now the board's gone exactly how I want it. So it's time for me to start kicking butt.
Wait, aren't that Tim's first time, first player now?
Oh, is it? Oh, darn.
Yeah,
it's okay.
You are just
for once again.
So you want us to all die. You're not really doing anything.
Yeah.
I had to go get my own dragon pile.
You're like, I want to see it. You just be first player?
Just saying.
You know that you can play Zombicide alone, right?
I mean, not in this case, you need us.
Yeah.
But.
So
it is a single player
game. I'm telling
you,
alternate rules. Awesome.
I'm going to go ahead and just start shooting at these two here because I've got the range to do so.
Oh, nice.
So, first roll. Rolled a one and miss, of course.
Nice. Not so nice.
Yeah, not so nice. Second one, hit and is dead. And my third and final action because I should be okay for now. Fire and kill that one too.
Oh, so a couple of experience.
Now, if only I had that orcish crossbow.
Yeah, that'd be crazy.
All right, your turn.
All right. So I'm actually going to move here for a minute and try to take care of this business.
Yeah, because that's one of the objectives is to kill the Necromancer, right?
Because we want one of these spawn points to go away.
Yeah.
And we want to win. All right, so
he's dead.
Three hits. All right. Do they both go away?
They both die.
Yeah, nice.
Boom.
That's how good I am.
Is it here?
Yeah.
Here.
I'm right here. Sorry. And let's go ahead and take a couple of these.
This went away from last turn.
Yep. Yeah. And that one too.
Oh, yep.
All right. So spent that one action doing that and the free spell. So I will go ahead and let's see. Two. All right. So I'm here now. I've got two actions left. I'm going to use one of those actions to switch out the shield because I'm untouchable with the dragon bile, and I will then spend my final action to go ahead and throw the dragon bile right into there. Set up a nice little trap. Go ahead and discard that one over there for me, and yeah, there we go.
All right, and Spencer, I believe it's your turn to hopefully get out of that room.
Well, I can't because I'm still in blue, so that means I only have three actions, and there are three zombies. And as with previous Zombicide, the rules are for each zombie that's in there takes one additional point to move out. So three zombies takes 3 points. I only have 3 points, so the only option is to go to Hammertown.
Hammertown.
Yeah. So that I could use my crossbow, which is pretty good. But it does take an extra reload after I use it one time, and I do have my starting ability is plus one die to melee. So I'm gonna roll my hammer using my two dice. I need a 4+ to hit. Well, I hit one. So I take that. that bumps me up into yellow, so I automatically get granted that additional action. So now I have three actions.
Awesome. Keep going.
I'm just going to keep going. I'm not going to try to leave. I'm going to keep going. I kill another. It should have been two, but I kill another one. And I am selecting my target. Oh, I am selecting my targets poorly. I should have been hitting that runner.
Yeah.
But
don't worry.
All right. It's all right. I still have two. I still have two actions left. Yeah.
You're a warrior.
Yeah.
You never miss.
Boom. Boom. Got him. I could have used those two successes on the other one. So there you go. There's my three. I have one action left.
Charge this room.
I think I'm just going to step back out. Hey, guys. I was looking around. And just don't go in there.
Huh.
Yeah. So.
Good job.
That is my turn.
Yeah. Yeah, this is looking a little dangerous here, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and go 1, 2, 3.
Huh.
Just try to get past the danger?
Yeah, just run away.
No, I'm leading them.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, look at that X. It's pretty open right
now. Yeah, I mean.
All right, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Do this.
As I said.
So we'll move these up first. All right. Let's move these here.
Room.
I'll go into that room over there. And he is actually going to end up in that room.
Yeah.
And you also have a runner.
Oh, I didn't see him.
It's going to come out.
Oh, good.
He only has one action. No action.
That, and then, all right.
There, and then we got to move all the other guys.
He goes into here. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Looking and good.
These guys are into here.
Oh, and these guys didn't get moved, did they?
I did. I already moved them.
Okay.
All right, so we're supposed to spawn, but actually one of the things we need to do is we've killed the Necromancer, so we need to select which of these spawns we want to get rid of. So we could get rid of the purple one, which is the one that he brought in, but what do you guys think? Which one do you think is the best for us to get rid of?
I say we get rid of this one.
Yeah, I was
going
to
say that.
This red one.
I say we get rid of this one, because the nun's got that.
No, you got that.
The nun has that locked down, so I think we're all in agreement that this is the one to get rid of.
The red one will go. All
right. And then we get to, this one turns just into a
permanent spawn.
A permanent spawn point.
Yeah. All right, so let's spawn.
All right.
We're taking care of his spawn points.
All right, let's do what we can to get him some action.
Everybody. Yeah, so we get four walkers.
Nice.
Sounds like a little bit of action for him.
Would have liked maybe like 4 to 8 runners, but.
And then down the other one in the stall there, one fatty.
I'll never be able to get in there again. Yeah, come on.
All right. Now it is.
Fatties are the pain of my existence.
Your turn.
So I have this torch. I'm going to spend an action to bring it into my hand. And then I'm going to spend an action to discard it into that dragon vial.
Yeah! Killing that abomination and the Fatty. Taking the tile off the board. Nice work, man.
Thank you.
5 XP. The Abomination is the big bad boy of the game, so he does give you 5 XP.
Hey, and that puts me into...
Orange. Great.
Which is really good. So now I'm in the orange danger level, and I get a choice. I have an extra magic action, or I have a spellbook. And spellbook would let me use any spell in my backpack as if it was equipped in my hand.
Oh, nice.
So...
That's really cool.
But you know what? I'm actually just going to go with that free magic action.
Oh.
Because I like that Inferno spell.
It's like throwing that Inferno spell around.
Yeah. So, I've done 2 of my regular actions. I will now take a third. And let me do one of my free attacks into here. Get these guys out of the way. And that is...
3 successes.
3 successes.
Take your 3 XP. Ooh. And you're killing it right
doesn't
now.
Doesn't it go off in their area?
No, it goes off in his. He fired it from there.
Okay.
All right.
I know what you're thinking. It blew up. But...
Yeah, you
know.
Then, you've got that. So I'm just going to go ahead and stay
you
there.
Have this. Because there's no fatties here.
Just going to go ahead and... All right. And I got it.
So he's dead.
He's dead. No little experience point here. No little noise marker there. So now that I've done all that work... I just go ahead and bring this shield up, you know, just in case.
Just in case.
Just in case. All right. So, now...
It's my move. I'm going to kill this walker, man. That's not walker. This runner. Sorry. I'm going to kill this runner because I don't like him. Look at all these guys that are hot on my tail, by the way.
He likes you.
Killed him. Dead.
He's dead.
Boom. Nice. And I'm up. And you know what? I'm going to search. Because I haven't really done a lot of searching this
treat
game.
Yourself.
I'm going to treat myself to some Dragon Vial. Really helpful.
All you need is a torch.
Yeah.
Drink that.
So,
all right, wait, now, instead of putting that in your pack, can't you equip it immediately?
Actually, yeah, that's a good point, Steve.
And,
I'm going to...
And toss it as an action.
You don't need that crossbow. Who needs that?
Well, the problem is I don't have a...
I need the crossbow.
I don't have a
torch. Don't worry about it.
So, but I'm going to give the crossbow to who it belongs to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the dragon file in my hand just in case.
Yeah, that's true.
Because I could drop it right here. If these guys get out in there, I could...
Yeah, that's true. You could do some fun with it.
If I can find a torch. So that's my two actions. I'm going to go... Three. And... Just go over here and go for it. See what my bros are doing.
So here, let me point out something really kind of you.
Yeah.
You did pass the guy who uses the crossbow.
It's
done. Hand off the piece. I mean, it's done.
No, we can.
But,
I'm sorry. We can go back here. Oh, hey, guy. And then they'll do my final action will be to trade the. I was just in the zone, man. I was seeing those X's.
I understand how you talk about what you're going to do, and then when you're about to do it, you immediately do something completely.
So I give you the crossbow, and you can reorganize for free if you would like.
Well, of course I'm going to.
And I just go. Sorry, I was so wrapped up in it.
No, that's okay.
All right. Well, as much as I'd like to make my first kill of the game, and I really would, there's a big fat X all by itself right next to me.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go one.
You're gonna go back one.
Back one.
Yeah. Run away.
Tactical retreat.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna open that door.
Maybe. What are you
doing?
No,
I'm not gonna open the door.
All
right. I'm gonna smash all the pieces.
You definitely didn't open it. You got another shot though.
Bam! There we go.
It's opened.
Crash.
Did you not roll the die?
And I throw it at the zombie. It's the only way I'm gonna kill one.
Everything on the board.
Yes. And then you put down some noise for breaking the door open twice because you. You were really putting some weight into it.
That's right.
Well, good job.
Kind of screwed up my plan, though. I expected to be in here by this next turn.
And
in this keg of turn, I'm going to go like, sup, Steve A's.
What up?
Oh, except he's still going to go, sup, Steve A's, because the closest, loudest part of the map is right there.
Yeah, this is going to be good.
All right. So I guess it's my turn. With this shiny new orcish crossbow that was so generously given to me.
You're welcome.
I'm gonna go ahead and fire into this zone here. Now I'm rolling two dice. And I hit on a two or better. That's a one, six and a five, so that's two dead.
Bam.
Nice.
And I'm gonna spend one action to reload.
All right.
And my third and final action, fire again. And I actually hit with that too, because again, I'm great with ranged.
Yeah.
Which actually bumps me up into having plus one action.
Welcome to the club.
It's a really good club.
Oh, you should mark yours.
So in that case, I guess I will go ahead and just fire in the longbow with my final action and see if I can kill the fast walker, which I do with a two.
Boom. He's good with that bow.
Good job.
All right, that's the end of my turn.
Attacking things feels good, doesn't it?
It does, it's fantastic.
So playing the game, as they say,
yeah.
Steve.
I just realized.
Playing the game.
I kind of screwed up by missing the door in the first roll.
Yeah.
Because now what's going to happen is I'm going to come in, I'm going to get tangled up with that zombie.
Yeah.
And the extra actions that it's going to take for me to get to there is going to leave me one short of picking up the axe. Denied experience points again.
Yeah, okay. You just.
You'll get used to it.
You just got a chance.
Well, I'm used to it.
So it's all right, it's
so
zombie.
Now
moves.
It's time to move. Yes. So.
You know, these guys are going all the way over there.
And there's a runner in there.
There is.
Where is he? I got him.
Nice.
And he jumps out.
Oh, right there.
All right, so this zombie moves up. Zombies are moving.
Yeah, they're moving now. Yep. So one of the reasons we should point out, the reason they've changed directions is that's loudest spot on the map and the door's open. So the path has changed so that it's clear. Yep.
Into the vault. He walks into this room. Things are getting a little cozy for Steve over there.
Nice.
I like it.
Now we spawn. So we'll spawn down there by Tim. And we got two walkers. Nope. Oh, wait. Sorry. Okay. We've got two fatties because you're in orange now.
There we are.
And we get down there. We get, a double spawn.
So it comes back over here.
So it's going to come back over there. And we're going to do one runner,
No, we're going to do...
Three fatties.
What is going
Why
on?
Why are you in orange?
Because I'm really good.
Yeah.
And why can't you read?
All workers. All.
All. All. Well, they get one activation. It's an activation. Read top to bottom, Steve. This is how we read. Top to bottom. They all get one activation.
You're a teacher, right?
Art teacher. He's not really.
Oh, wait. You don't need to read for that. Hey. Okay.
If they move, if that was a pictograph, I would have heard.
So they move.
Oh, Steve, you're so
lucky. No, they're not going to move that way, buddy. They're going to move.
Oh, yeah, that's
you're
right.
You're so lucky. You got these guys in there now. And they're going to lose you guys. Yeah. Oh, wait.
All of that.
Oh, no.
Hey, guys. It seems the wise wizard is the only one who is just doing so well.
That dragon, if I really had that...
Do these guys move in also?
No, they're not walkers. They're not walkers.
All right, okay.
They walk, but they're not walkers.
Okay. Spencer, I guess you got to start this turn up. Yeah. Hopefully you start swinging away pretty well there.
So, I have this dragon bottle, but I don't have a torch. Nobody has a torch, right?
He's got an inferno spell.
No.
Doesn't? It's got to be a torch. I think so.
Obviously.
It's not a torch.
All right, so here's what's going to happen.
It's a magic, magic fire.
I'm going
fire.
To
Which
swing.
Which fire?
Two. All right, you guys... I'm going to kill these zombies.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. All right, two dice for my hammer. I kill one. It's going to be the runner. That's going to be the first guy.
Sure?
It's really important that it's the runner.
All right.
That's
one
action.
I thought you had to follow the order
that's one
of
action.
Not
on melee.
Oh, okay.
Not on melee. So on melee, you pick your targets, man. So that's one action. Here we go. I kill one. That's two. Ah, three and four.
All right.
So
two
more, yeah. And how many have I done? Three so far?
You have one more.
I get one more.
Oh, no. You can do it.
If I can kill two, I'll be okay because we can share the damage. I killed two more.
We'll take it.
Nice, so I bumped up to 15. So we only got two guys to deal with. And now it's your turn, Steve.
All right. I guess I have to finally fight someone. Yeah.
Just to avoid the confusion here.
Yeah.
Technically, I could take all three actions to retreat, but I don't go to guys like this. Here.
Yeah.
Finally.
Oh, I only get one die, though. I'm like you and your special
I'm
skills.
Awesome. I'm a good warrior.
Bam! Four.
Oh, you do kill him. Yeah.
One experience point.
Steve, are you on the? You're on the board.
I'm on the board.
I gotta say that Steve actually did something in this game. Nice.
Zero is also in the blue, just for the record.
No, you know, zero. Is.
All right, and boom, another dead one. And then for my third action, I'll take my bloodlust and skate in here and attack.
All right. One dead.
One more.
Ow.
So
saving that up.
You blood rushed. I'm sorry, excuse me. You bloodlusted into the huge stack of zombies.
Yeah.
Just three of them. Four of them.
You're fine. I'm sure you're
this.
Fine.
Yeah.
I'm sure
I got you're this. Fine. No problem. I got leather armor.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. You do have leather
sure
armor.
Sure, you're fine.
Yeah.
Okay. So I guess it's my turn.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to go ahead and start off with the orcish crossbow in that little room right there. Hopefully we just won't take any damage at all.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hit on two up. That's a four and a five, so that's two dead.
Nice. Boom, nice.
Good job.
And then I'm going to go ahead and spend an action to reload. And I'm going to go ahead and fire my longbow at this zombie here, which it dies. And then my fourth action, I'm going to start moving down this way to help out Steve, because he's about to get just absolutely slaughtered.
I got this.
All right, that's the end of my turn.
All right. Now it's me. I'm gonna go ahead and spend one of my actions move here. Now look at the nun. She's got that.
It looks good. I'm sure the nun can kill those three zombies.
I got this.
All right, so we're going into here. That's okay, that's okay. So one of them goes away.
One dies, which is gonna be one of the walkers.
Yes. That's fine.
And we get a noise token. Noise.
All right, so I'll take another one of my three magic actions here.
And kills everything
three
else
hits.
In the room.
Oh, don't worry, guys, I got this.
Getting ready yet?
Not yet. Yeah. Oh. Hmm. So I spent one action, two actions, three actions. Thanks for opening the door. Let's see what this is.
You got it.
Oh, yeah. Nice. And that's the blue X we need to actually win the scenario, because we've killed the Abomination, we've killed the Necromancer, and we found the blue X.
So, when you say we, though, I killed the Abomination, I killed the Necromancer, and I found the blue X.
I opened the door. You couldn't even get through a door.
I did all of that by myself.
You couldn't even get through the door.
I shot some stuff.
And with the help of you two, with the help of the Mighty Warrior and our Archer friend.
You couldn't get
through
that
door. And
I can't
remember if there was anyone else on our adventure.
So,
how is it I'm the only guy fighting zombies here at the end of the game?
Oh,
what's up with that?
Because you waited until the end of the game to actually do anything.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Let the record show.
You know what? You did help open the door.
I most, carried your dragon.
Most valuable. Most valuable door opener.
I carried your extra dragon bow.
All right. Just in case.
Alright guys, well that was Zombicide Black Plague, and we were successful, which is very unusual for a Zombicide game, but as I said earlier, we did modify the rules a little bit to try to kind of speed the game up while also taking time to explain the new rules changes, the new character classes and stuff like that. So basically, you know, we knew the game would run a little bit longer with rules explanations in there, so we kind of shortened the scenario a little bit so that we'd have time to explain rules and movement and spawning and upgrades and new items and stuff like that. Awesome. Ton of fun so far.
Yeah. I really like it.
And let's just all agree that Steve is the worst.
Yeah.
Probably.
Definitely. And Inferno is definitely
Inferno is amazing, especially when this guy has it.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you guys for playing with me. Thank you guys for watching. And make sure you check out the Kickstarter while it's running. And check out the game on the Facebook page, the Geek Team Games Facebook page, and the Cool Mini or Not Facebook page.